Hello everyone, I'm Transyuti, and this is the 500 subscriber special, and the first part of What If Tanjiro Was a Grey Jedi. The first Kimetsu no Yaiba What If, where I'll need to watch the original series while I'm writing. But not for part zero, because it's part zero. Man, this video took way too long to get out. I'm so sorry this took so long, but I wrote myself into a corner, and it took so long to figure out what I could do without compromising the quality of the story. Anyway, a lot of you may not know what a Grey Jedi is. To explain what a Grey Jedi is, I need to explain something else. You see, the Jedi Order, when you really think about it, is a morally corrupt space cult. As someone who used to be part of a cult, it's very obvious to me. If you're still feeling doubtful, then check out the videos in the iCards. You'll find a film theory on the topic of the Jedi Order being messed up, as well as a playlist that goes through the bite model, a model used to determine whether or not something is a cult. So the Jedi Order isn't great, but the Sith are obviously a no-go, so Grey Jedi are the best option. True Grey Jedi are those who use both the light and dark side of the Force, but the Jedi Order says any Force user who isn't a straight-up Sith who goes against anything the Jedi Order says is a Grey Jedi. Maybe I'll put a video on that in the iCards, too. Well, I hope you enjoy! Roll intro! Tanjiro's eyes were closed. He was only 5, yet he was forced to learn an entirely new and difficult language, as well as rewrite everything he knew. He wasn't allowed to open his eyes for this training. He held the faux lightsaber in his hand. He wasn't supposed to think about where his opponent was. He was told to just let the Force guide him. He held his saber up and blocked the strike from his opponent. He countered, but his own strike was blocked as well. He swung forward and the faux lightsabers clashed. The two opponents pushed against each other. Tanjiro pushed and headbutt his opponent. Both their headgear broke. Tanjiro! He flinched. Without the headgear, he could now see clearly. His teacher was right in front of him. What have we talked about?
A Jedi is not to use any weapon aside from their lightsaber.
Then why did you attack your opponent with your head?
I just figured there was an opening.
Stop it! Tanjiro bowed.
Gonmen nasai, Kalin sensei!
What was that?
I'm sorry, Master Kalin.
Tanjiro briefly spoke in his native tongue. His harsh teacher tried to pound it out of him as best he could, but he spoke Japanese as much as he could get away with. He didn't want to forget the language of his homeland. You must forget your past. It is holding you back. Repeat the Jedi Code.
There is no emotion. There is peace. There is no ignorance. There is knowledge. There is no passion. There is serenity. There is no chaos. There is harmony. There is no death. There is the Force. The Jedi Code. It was fed into him and his fellow younglings every day. He had been on Coruscant for a little more than 3 years now. He didn't miss his family any less.
He wasn't allowed to contact or even think about them. He wasn't supposed to feel any emotions. Supposedly, they led to the dark side. Every day he was given the same lessons and the same training. He felt as if he was going crazy. He probably would have if not for R3S8, an astromech droid that was occasionally able to interact with him. He considered them his only friend in this strange world far from home. And he considered himself even more lucky that they could learn any language, so he could speak Japanese around them, and they'd understand. Even if R3S8 was hard to understand, they were the only thing keeping him sane. Well, that and one other thing he would try at night. He would try to figure things out for himself. If Master Kalin found out, he would be punished for sure. So he was as quiet as possible. Over time, he became able to smell midichlorians, the living things that generated the Force. Through this, he was able to tell that Jedi masters had far more than him and his fellow younglings. One night, he overheard something. He put his ear to the door. He listened in on any conversation he could.
The Sith sound like they were most troublesome.
Indeed, most historical records say they could cloud a Jedi's ability to sense them. This caused Tanjiro's interest to peak.
Do you think it was really a Sith that Qui-Gon Jinn encountered?
Impossible. The Sith died out almost 4 millennia ago. The two voices walked away, and Tanjiro couldn't hear what they were saying anymore. A way to hide oneself from Jedi. This was what Tanjiro needed. He hadn't tried to escape because he knew the Jedi could just easily find him again. But if he could hide himself, but how could he learn it? As stated, the Sith died out a long time ago. He thought hard. Then he realized. Sith texts. If he could find some, he could learn. That plan still had a problem. Anything related to the Sith was held under tight lock and key. Even then, he had no idea where they were kept. The next day, he searched around the Jedi archives. Maybe something slipped through. It wouldn't be too strange to find a youngling in the Jedi archives in their spare time, so it wasn't suspicious. He was looking for anything, any clue as to where Sith artifacts might be. This wasn't getting him anywhere. He closed his eyes. He used the Force to sense around. He felt something, a prickling, darkness. He followed it. He reached a section. Whatever he was sensing was coming from the other side of the wall. He started moving over to the wall. Are you looking for something? Tanjiro turned around. He saw an old woman in yellow robes. It was the chief librarian of the archives, Jocasta Nu.
No, I was just finishing.
Tanjiro left the section and started heading towards the exit of the archives. As he was exiting the archives, he ran into something. He fell over and heard a familiar series of beeps and whistles. He looked up to see R3-S8.
I'm okay.
Tanjiro got back up. R3 looked at the archives.
The archives?
Tanjiro looked around, making sure no one was close enough to hear him.
Don't tell anyone, but I'm going to try and run away. Please be quiet. I don't want anyone to find out. I'm sorry, but please don't tell anyone. I miss my mother and father, and I can't stay here anymore. Please don't tell anyone. I'm going to try tonight, so we probably won't see each other again after this. I'm sorry, but goodbye.
They parted ways, and Tanjiro began to form his plan. That night, he stood next to the door of his quarters. He waited for the sense to clear. He opened his door, then closed it behind him. He carefully made his way through the halls of the Jedi Temple towards the archives. He at one point thought he was caught, but the Jedi continued down the halls, passing him by. He made it to the archives and snuck to the section where he previously felt the dark presence. He searched with the Force again. It guided him to a few select books. He pulled on them. He managed to remove them with the Force, but only barely. The wall moved, and Tanjiro looked at the artifacts in front of him. He grabbed as many books and artifacts as he could. He turned his head. It looked like a lightsaber, a real one. He grabbed it too. He stuffed everything he could into a bag and ran, not forgetting to grab some Jedi records on his way out. He paid attention to the smells around him. He avoided scents of any people while making his way to the spaceport. He was almost there when he heard some footsteps. He hid behind a corner. He tried to breathe slowly to conceal the sound. He was panicking. He covered his mouth.
"Come out from there,"
a voice said. It was Master Callan.
"I know you're in there, Tanjiro."
Tanjiro held still for a moment. Then he ran. He couldn't be caught. Not now. If he got caught now, he would never be able to escape again. Callan gave chase, sensing dark artifacts in the bag he carried with him. Tanjiro tripped and hit his head on the ground. Talon lifted him up with the force. Tanjiro looked back in fear. He started to cry. He tried to think of a way out. He looked to the bag. He reached into it, grabbing the lightsaber. He turned it on and threw it, hoping it would do something, anything, only for Master Talon to stop it with the force.
You are done, Tanjiro.
Tanjiro was in front of the Jedi High Council, stun cuffs on his wrists, and a bag of incriminating evidence in front of him. He was only 5 years old, yet he found and willfully stole many Sith artifacts from the hidden room in the archives.
Can we punish him like we would normally?
One council member said.
If it were one, we would simply send him to the farms. But he not only found Sith artifacts, but stole them. Several.
How did he even find them? Another asked.
I thought they couldn't be found, yet alone by a youngling.
He could be incredibly dangerous if we let him live,
a third said. Hearing those words, Tanjiro was terrified. They weren't going to kill him, right? He was a kid. He only wanted to go home.
Master Yoda,
one of the council members asked.
What do you think we should do? Could he become a threat?
The small green creature appeared to be deep in thought. He closed his eyes.
Difficult to see, the future is. Unsure, I am. Master Talon, Tanjiro's teacher, you are. Your thoughts?
Tanjiro has consistently ignored instructions. He is impossible to discipline. He, at the very least, cannot be allowed to be free.
The fear of the youngling in question only began to grow.
Very well,
Master Yoda said with a solemn look.
Imprisoned, he will be.
Tanjiro began to panic. No, please! A temple guard grabbed Tanjiro's arm and started to pull him away. I just wanted to go home! Tanjiro resisted as much as he could, but it was useless. I just wanted to go home! The temple guards dragged Tanjiro away. He pulled and pulled, but it was useless. Please, someone help! Suddenly, as they passed a landing pad, a loud sound went off and the guards fell. Tanjiro turned around and saw a ship pointed it in his direction. An astromech droid popped out of it.
R3?
R3 came over to Tanjiro and broke his stun cuffs with their blowtorch.
I'm okay.
R3 started heading to the ship.
Wait, I need the book so they won't find me.
R3-S8 turned around and opened their storage, revealing they had already stolen the bag of artifacts back for Tanjiro.
What? How?
R3 made some beeps and whistles, but Tanjiro could at most understand the tone.
Never mind, let's go.
Tanjiro grabbed the bag, and the two hurried to the ship and got in. R3 took control of the ship, and it started taking off. It went higher and higher until it was off-planet. Tanjiro heard a laser blast and looked through the window in the back. They were being pursued.
R3, we have to get away!
Tanjiro took cover. He started breathing quickly. He heard a bang. Another bang, and another. Tanjiro started to panic.
I don't want to die!
One last bang sounded and the ship went into the hyperspace. Tanjiro took many deep breaths before calming down. After a few minutes, he opened the bag and pulled out a Sith holocron he stole. He set it down on the ground in front of him. He looked at it. He grabbed it and tried to twist it open to no avail. He set it back down and looked at it. He remembered something about the Force being used to open holocrons. He focused the Force on the holocron for a few minutes. Nothing. Tanjiro looked at the holocron.
I'll figure it out later.
Tanjiro put the holocron back in his bag. He wandered to the cockpit of the ship and watched streaks of light pass the ship by. It was cold. He experienced hyperspace only once before. His memories of before were so vague, but he held onto them as strongly as he possibly could. He looked back. His parents' touch felt so warm. He was going to have a younger sibling, but he was taken away before they were born. He had no idea what agreeing to be trained by these Jedi would entail. He had no idea he would never see his family again. Now, he just wanted to go home. He was sleepy. That made sense. He didn't get much sleep. He had to stay up to escape. He watched the streaks of light pass them by as he slowly drifted to sleep. Tanjiro suddenly woke up. There was beeping and red lights. He looked out the window. It looked like his home planet. Was it? He hoped so, because if it wasn't,
he and R3 would be trapped. R3 came over to Tanjiro and started beeping. R3 started leading Tanjiro to the back of the ship. A door opened and R3 led Tanjiro inside. The extra room shot from the ship. The pod landed in the forest below. The door opened and Tanjiro climbed out.
We need to find a village or something.
Tanjiro started walking in a random direction. He had no idea of knowing where a village was, so all he could do was guess. He looked up at the moon, the one single moon. It had been so long since he had seen only one moon in the night sky. It gave him hope that they made it home. He continued walking. His legs started to get tired pretty quickly. After thinking a bit more, he realized, even though it was dark, the trees looked like the trees where he was from. The sounds and smells, too. His memories weren't the most clear, but over the course of the 3 years, he had held on to them as best as he could. His hope grew more and more. He kept walking. He walked as far as his legs could take him, which wasn't very far considering he was only a child. Breaks were frequent. During one of those breaks, his stomach growled.
I'm fine.
Tanjiro waved off his hunger. A few minutes later, it was back to walking as the sun began to rise. The sun shone through the leaves as Tanjiro forced his legs to keep going. After a bit, he saw something up ahead. He started going faster. He broke through the tree line and... a path. He was standing before a path. On the other side was a rice field. He looked up and down the path and saw someone. A human. Was it true? Did he make it to his home planet? He ran to the person down the path.
Excuse me? He asked the man in Japanese. What planet am I on?
Earth? The man responded. It was true. Tanjiro was back on Earth. He made it. Not only that, but the man understood his language. That meant he even made it to his home country. He began to cry tears of joy.
I made it! I made it back!
The man asked Tanjiro some questions. What he was doing here, where his parents were, what the strange metal creature following him around was, stuff like that. He didn't believe a lot of his responses, but he offered to bring him back to his home. After all, it wasn't too far away. After half a day's journey, he saw it, in the horizon. His home village. He got out the car and started running. Home. It was just up the mountain. He could make it. It was so close. He ran through the town. People saw him run past. They didn't recognize him. At most, they wondered who he was and why he was in such a hurry. He ran out onto the mountain path. He kept running. Familiar, comforting scents filled his nose. He kept going up the path. He kept coming closer and closer. The smell of charcoal was prevalent in the air. His parents sensed. He could smell them. They were close. He could see his home. He stopped. He looked around. Laundry was hung up. He watched the door open. A woman came out and started putting the dry laundry in the basket. She turned.
Tanjiro?
He ran up to his mom and hugged her.
Mother!
He started crying.
Mother, I miss you so much! I'm sorry I left! I'll never leave again!
She knelt down and hugged him. That day, Tanjiro reunited with his parents and met his little sister Nezuko and his little brother Takeo. Tanjiro continued studying the text he stole. He had to learn how to hide his presence as soon as possible. He also practiced with the stolen lightsaber. It was a possibility that he could be found by coincidence. In that event, he needed to know how to defend himself and his family. Over time, his family grew accustomed to Tanjiro studying, as well as his special abilities that he honed over the years. One day, his father grew ill. Tanjiro told him there might be a way he could save him, but he declined. He knew his time had come, and he passed away. From there, Tanjiro had to take care of his family. At this point, he had studied the text he stole best he could, but he had only mastered the first two forms of lightsaber combat. Shicho, the basics, and Makashi, the style created specifically to combat other lightsaber wielders.
He had also mastered many force techniques, including the one that masked his own presence from force users. Could he protect himself and his family should the Jedi find him? He didn't know.
And that was part zero of What If Tanjiro Was a Gray Jedi. I really hope you enjoyed it. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Writing this was a mammoth challenge because of writing myself into a corner, and how in the last bit I struggled to figure out what to put in there. Not to mention how complicated Star Wars lore is. I did so much research, but how long have I been writing this script? I think 3/4 of a year, or maybe just a whole year. I'm glad I'm finished writing. Also, if you would like to get new updates about videos, notifications of when they drop, as well as notifications for when I start streaming, because I stream on Twitch now, you can join my Discord, the link to which is down in the description. Also, please join my Patreon. Money has been pretty tight lately, and every little bit helps. For the lowest tier, you can get behind-the-scenes trivia and an occasional side story. For tier 2, you get sneak peeks and the ability to influence what videos I do next. Finally, the highest tier patrons get to watch premiered videos like this one as soon as I finish them, rather than when they premiere on YouTube. Link to all my shit is down in the description, and until next time, matatare!